Your conference is called Science and Non-Duality. But as we understand science today, by definition, it is dualistic. So science and non-duality, the two phrases actually don't go together because science is based on subject-object split. I'm the observer, and that's what I observe, the physical universe. Non-duality means the observer, which is me, and this universe, they're one unified holistic activity. So by definition, science cannot give us the experience or knowledge of non-duality. Having said that, we could create a new science, which would say that subjective experiences are as valid as objective reality, so-called, because in my view, there's no objective reality. It's a concept that there's an objective reality. All we know is what we experience in our consciousness as qualities of consciousness. But we could say that the scientific paradigm itself would have to shift. The problem with that is science is based on what is called empirical measurement. Empiricism implies that if I can see something, measure it, give it units of mass and energy, you observe the same thing, then it's real. But that even is a metaphysical idea. The empirical world is less than 0.01% of the universe. Even with what we know today, between dark energy, dark matter, you have 96% of the universe. That leaves 4%, which is atomic, but then most of that is invisible interstellar dust. The visible universe, with all its galaxies and stars and trillions of planets, is 0.01% atomic. But then atoms are also waves. Waves have no location in space-time. So when we say empirical, what are we meaning? Science has brought us to the portal of the sub-empirical. And now we cannot go beyond that door. Because once you say sub-empirical, there's nothing to measure. Okay, and yet what we measure is like a little crest on the vast ocean of sub-empirical reality, which many wisdom traditions call the unmanifest, the invisible, which is where the action is happening. Some people call it unconscious mind, but we don't, those of us who navigate the unconscious mind through yoga and other methodologies. How can you call it unconscious? It's the mind that never sleeps. It's running the universe right now.